Hello, friends, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die Alpha 10.2. We are on the update. This is Rongo the Bold, your host. And I spent all last night and most of this morning with the clock slowed down, hard at work. Yes, I have been hard at work. I went a little silly with that. It's a little overkill for an entry point, but it's secure. I had to make a few modifications because I ran into some problems with zombies during the construction. I did some more TNT mining over there, took that back a little farther. I still need to chew it out a little bit more, TNT to be gathered. But I have done a lot of upgrades and modifications to the base, so I'm going to show you all of those. And I've got the game set on a longer day today, and we're going to go ahead and run into the hub city again and do another little adventure. But I also want to do a little bit of showing you some building with the nail gun, because I think it's just freaking awesome. It makes building so much faster. So anyway, yes, we have another entry over here. So there's the back door. I can make that drop. So anyway, this is the back door. This was before, remember, the corner of the house. And what I've done is just put a wood plank out, and then I chewed this back farther, dynamited some of it, and then just swung my axe for a good chunk of it, and built this kind of little area. And basically, we got a door here, doubly upgraded, and then, we got that down. I need to put spikes around here still, because I've had zombies come up and just, just bashing their fists. You can see a little bit of damage. Tiny bit of damage there, which is all gone. But they just beat on that, and it's annoying. So I'll put spikes in here. Oh, see, every time you use the nail gun, you get this weird light trail effect. Anyway, I hope that doesn't become annoying through the whole day. Built that other little, sally port, whatever you want to call it. Put down another small metric shit ton of spikes. Look at all the spikes. I had to chop down my entire forest. It's replanted now, and I actually counted. I've got 80 trees over there. So if you think about 80 times 7, would be 560 logs that I can get out of that one little alcove. So right now it's all back to treelings. So anyway, I made this little monolithic entry. And then over here, I've started, look at this. So I chewed back the wall, and then chewed it back there as well. And then I started putting up a concrete inner wall. I am just about out of iron. I used all my iron ore. I've got like maybe a dozen ingots left. So I need to mine a lot more ore. I even got some more iron, maybe another 20 or so ore when I was mining this out. But I'm coming up short on the iron ore. So more iron ore needed. Anyway, so what I did is I farmed it, mined it all back, and then I lined it with spikes. They only upgraded once, but they're good enough. And the reason why I have these up on top here is, while I was working on this, the zombies would walk up here and walk out and drop down and walk all the way around and then drop off. So I had to finish off some zombies, and then I had to come back. And I just, before I built this thing, I actually went ahead and just put spikes down, so they were dying on the spikes. It was kind of funny. So anyway, those defenses on this side are now pretty freaking secure. What I wanted to show you, I've got enough right now. I want to show you just how fast you can build with this freaking nail gun. So watch this. Oops. I don't want to upgrade 3 times. It's actually so hard to not upgrade twice. Oops. And that's just like that. Nope. I'm not. Oh, it's this, it's a stupid plant is causing me grief. There we go. You know, I don't know if I'll actually be able to make it. So what I may do is I may make this a kind of a cutscene episode where I do a little bit of work today, and then I will cut to going into the hub city. I still need to do obviously more work. I still have how much more log do I have? I've still got a lot of logs left. So there's all my tree farm. Look at that! Isn't that amazing? anyway, so I need to bring the wall around. I need to put spikes down in front of it as well. Oops, I gotta put frames up now to get those inside pieces. Oops, how do I? See, I just love it. It's just so freaking fast. So I've been getting good feedback from the community, both in terms of just the general gameplay and everything. And I really appreciate all the support. It's really been interesting, interesting dynamic experience, and been really fun. So I'm really glad everyone's enjoying it, and I'm gonna do my best to continue to provide some good entertainment. I had one suggestion for another game to play, Project Zomboid. And I happen to have Project Zomboid, and I think that would be good. I am not good at it. I have a lot to learn. I've only played it just for a few hours, so I will not be nearly as able to give suggestions and opportunities for improvement as I can with this game. But maybe that'll be fun. You know, you can learn with me. So I got a second entry point here, all massive. I put a nice firing point in there, so let's go inside and look at this. This is the regular steel door, just upgraded twice, which is really cool looking. I mean, look at that. I think this looks badass. That's the hard metal door, upgraded twice. So I got this little ladder up here. So I got a little firing point. Pew, 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 pew. So that's good. And then I've got the major, you know, the down. So when you get down here, you can just, oops, you gotta go up a little bit higher. You kind of jump off. Ugh. And then you got this platform. So this is our original, the original little hut is right here. And I went ahead and just put a lip around it to protect it. Then I connected it over to the wall. And then I added these stairs up to the second floor, so it makes it much easier to come in and out, and stairs down here to the kind of main floor. So we have, I mean, it's pretty freaking secure. I've got a few, I misplaced the concrete block. They are a bitch to take out. You got to swing your hammer, your pickaxe at those things for a while to break them out. So I haven't fixed that one yet, and I still need to make two more to fit in there. A little more going down in the hole, but I need to get a little more iron out of everything. So I got quite to mine that area over there back, and I know that there's some iron on that side, and I know there's iron back there, so I may end up having to mine back there as well. However, oh man, so zombies are hurting my spikes. I got a little misplaced spike there as well. Some of it I just didn't bother cleaning up, but so obviously you can see that I've got a lot more spikes placed. Spikes are now everywhere underneath, all done up. I upgraded a bunch of them, but then I basically have run out of iron just about. So I'm going to hold off on any more upgrading for the time being. All of our crops are just gorgeous. We got so much foods. Those corns have not grown their tops back, and it's been several days now, so I think that it does not grow back. So just kind of confirming that when you're pulling your corn, go ahead and pull the whole thing, because it does not grow back. And I wonder if Well, dang computer thing. I want to throw this recording device possibly through a nearby window. I'm going to try, I'm probably going to pick up a copy of, Action is what I've heard is really good recording software. Maybe, guys, in the comments, let me know if you have had good experience with certain recording software or not. I've heard there are issues with Fraps with 7 Days to Die, so I'm gonna try Action. I've heard good things about that one, but anyway, let me know in the comments. So I had come down my little Hopog PVR Gaming Edition 2 recording box, decided to not show you the harvesting of the corn, but I had pointed out that you do get seven off of a fully grown. Well, that's weird. These are different. I was getting seven off of the other ones, and these are 1, 2. So that's 42, 45, 3. Yeah, I was getting seven off of the shorter corns. That's weird. Anyway, I pulled up the row of corn, and I put down more potatoes, because we're much shorter. We have so much more corn than we have potatoes. So anyway, then I came over here and I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to do a little zombie summoning ritual. And then I point out that sucks. Okay, so what I'm going to do is put some oil barrels down. And those explode nicely. I'm out of TNT right now. Come on. Get up. Okay. There we go. I'm so glad they fixed it. I mean, it used to be you couldn't do this. You had to be so careful with your crops. I used to build like little raised planter boxes, all nice, you know, little walkways around them, and had them all, you know, carefully lined up so I wouldn't actually touch them, because you had to have water within 4 blocks. So I had like little water areas, and I had to be so much more careful about farming. Now, literally just hoe the ground, and boom, you're done. I like it. It's a huge improvement. It makes things much easier for mining or farming. That's called farming. So anyway, we got this. I'm going to go ahead. You know, I wonder, does the nail gun... Okay, the nail gun does not... Oh, that's the other thing I did. I think in this forge? Yes. I've got 96 nails. So let's see how this thing does against zombies. Alright, if all else fails, use a pistol. Okay. Alright, here we go. Okay, that should summon some zombies. Basically, I want to summon some zombies, and I want you guys to see how everything works now. Oh, look at... I think it's a little bit of a glitchy weirdness. Look at down at my trigger finger in the gun. There's a nail. Okay, let's see if it's still there. It's not with my potato. It is with the gun. That's bizarre. The little itsy bitty bug. Alright, I'm going to put... I put this gravel and log spikes. This is kind of, I kind of made an outdoor chest to save me from going in and out all the time. See all my extra soil I've got now for the other spot. Well, let's keep half of it on here. How am I doing? Oh, I'm freaking starving to death. Blueberry pie. It doesn't smell. But it only gives you 20 wellness back, or 20 back. And for the cost, I mean, it's an egg, corn flour, so that means you got to use 2 corn, an egg, and water, and a blueberry to get 20 wellness. So I think as far as, you know, cost-wise, it's a lot more expensive for a blueberry pie, so I'm definitely going to reserve it just for special treats. Zombies? Really? No zombies. All of that and no zombie. I absolutely love the new defenses. I mean, this is just badass. Only thing I wish I had done is I wish I had put in some firing ports, maybe some iron bars through here as well, so I could, you know, see out. Maybe if I get really bored, I could pickaxe my way through that as well. I mean, it's a lot of pickaxing. All right, but I can come up here at least and do this bit. But no hordes. All right, let me go. Let's see if I can make some dynamite here. I'm also really loving the new get down quickly on the staircase. I should have done that a long time ago. Okay, gunpowder, paper. All we need is some grass. Or plant fibers, I should say. Let's go up out this one here. I love that he can run up ladders now. It's awesome! Okay. Get a bunch of grass. I like that the only thing actually limiting me now on TNT is plant fibers. Of course, we always need more books. Still have a decent supply left. You know, in the early part of the game, there's a tendency to not pick up books and paper and bullet casings and that kind of stuff. I strongly encourage you, even if you have to just create a chest and throw it somewhere that you remember, grab that stuff early on, because it pays to be collecting that stuff from, you know, minute zero in the game. There comes a point where you just need all that brass. Wow, those trees grow so quick. Look at that. They were just little... That's just a little ridiculous. But they were little, you know, planting little seeds just a few minutes ago. Alright, I really hope the pimps are working on the light issue after using the nail gun. That's kind of annoying. Okay, that's plenty of plant fibers. Okay. TNT. Dynamite. Alright, let's see if this summons the little wee beasties. Yay, I actually didn't hit the thingamajigger. What's it called? Spike. I so regularly just run over and hit the spike, so. Whee! Oh, and also, you guys didn't notice, I think I pointed out already that my broken leg is gone. Not the broken leg, but the splint icon. So basically, they've got it fixed now so that it goes away. I'm not thirsty. That's nice that I'm not thirsty. Why are you telling me that I'm not thirsty? Alright, come on. It's over here. So yeah, they fixed it. So it was that little bug where it would try to remember that for far too long. Alright. If that don't summon some bad people, I don't know what will. Do-do-do-do-do. Oh, I put down the... Are those? Did I put them down backward? What the heck? It looks backward, doesn't it? That's weird. That's what I get for putting furniture out when it's dark. Okay, come on, really? Not a single spider zombie after all of that? Does it say? No, it doesn't say, Aww. I wonder if I can. Alright. Minor cheat coming up, folks. Be warned. If you're feeling like a complete purist, do not watch. Close your eyes. I'm going to go into debug mode. And then I'm going to go in. If I can remember what menu it is. And I'm going to spawn a spider zombie. Yeah, you summon. Yeah, you do. You call. Oh, yeah, I'm here. Alright, let's see if he triggers a horde. Yeah, you tell everybody. Tell your friends. Don't die too early or anything. Okay. Now I hope that they'll actually trigger. Ooh, hear that weird like gurgly noise? That's disturbing. So anyway, I'm going to cut this video with me also going into the city. I've had a request from one of my subscribers, one of you wonderful folk, that they've never seen anyone go into the movie theater in the city. So I'm going to do that for the morning. Really? You died. You fell down in my pit trap. And you died. Well, you're supposed to do that, but still. Look at all these logs. I may have gone a little insane on the number of spiked logs. I'm just saying that I might need to seek some counseling. Someday I should upgrade those, too. Alright, well, if the no zombies want to come and play, then I guess I can't make them. There's nothing else I can do here for, Huh. Ooh, I can spawn 25. Ooh, from biomes. Huh. What is that? I might end up killing myself, so let me not worry about that right now. All right, well, I'm sorry that I wasn't able to trigger a horde, considering I blew off dynamite and I blew up oil barrels. I spawned my own little spider zombie, all for nothing. I'm gonna keep it up, and I'm going to go ahead and just jump cut to the horde that comes tonight, because I'm sure there'll be a horde coming. And I'll show you guys that, just so you can see the defenses at work. I'm going to go put some more torches out as well, so we can see a little better. And I will see you guys in a little bit. Got at least one spider zombie. Hello, spider zombie. Two spider zombies. We've got a third spider zombie over there. Nope, it's a regular horde, I think, coming in. So we've got horde action. Hello, horde action. Got dying zombies. So basically, I'm just gonna watch and just enjoy. Oh, look at them all falling off. Oh my god. Oh. Yeah, I'm just gonna repair some stuff while I'm here because, you know, I'm that unconcerned. And watch me die while I'm doing this. I need some more sticks. And you guys are going, don't not look! Alright, hang on. Let me just repair my crossbow. And then I'll look some more. Alright, one thing I'm worried about, because originally when I first put this up here, zombies would come in because I had left the bottom rung in. So I had to take that out. It'll be. You know, I've noticed the bees really don't attack very much anymore. Whatever new AI for the bees has been a little, I think, a little over-nerfed. Okay, you guys need to come over here because my defenses aren't set for that yet. It sounds like there might be a zombie that fell down behind the trees. I had one that happened, and they basically just start bashing trees apart back there. All right, you guys, I'm going to go ahead and kill. I wish I could see what was... Let me see if I can see what's going on over there. Oh. What was that? That was glass. Was that glass? What do I have that's glass? Oh, the house? Does the house have... Yeah, the house has glass windows, doesn't it? I wonder if they broke into the broke a little bit into that little house. Huh. Hey, doggy! Look at... Oh, that's not a dog. Hey, it's not a dog. That's a spider zombie going batshit. This guy over here. Let's kill you. And let's kill you. It's all kind of very peaceful. It's just like target practice. I hope it's light enough. I know it's kind of dark on my preview monitor, so I don't know if it will be light enough for you guys to see everything going on. I mean, it's happening in the middle of the night, so I don't know. This guy's going batshit. Will you please stop moving? How can I kill you when you're moving that fast? Oh, missed. You guys can see that one, right? I was just starting to make some more torches, too, and all this happened. There we go. I have some animal fat cooking so I can make some torches. Okay, yeah, I definitely need spikes in there just to protect that wall, because the idea is to get them not on the wall. So I'm not quite sure why I understand why they're attacking the wall. But I mean, I think everything's holding up really well. Yeah, overall, I'm fairly happy with the performance of the base. Oops. This is a little bit of a concern for me. Because I really need to have a lip here. Like I'm shooting the legs. I'm out of crossbow bolts! Holy crap. I've shot a lot of crossbow bolts. Let me see if I can kill this guy with a pistol then. Otherwise, he'll just sit there and gnaw on that forever. Alright. Another one down there? Come on, you little punk. Alright, let's go down real quick. Make some more crossbow bolts. Alright, well, I think you guys get the point. I think the base is pretty defensible now. Not really having any problems. No zombies coming even close to saying hi. So I think we have a win. I'm always going to leave space there so I can always come in front and repair the ones that they get beat up on. Obviously, gonna have to put more spikes down there, more spikes around that to protect that. But really, we're in really good shape. Now it's basically prettified. I want to put clay tiles, like bricks down there. And just so you guys, I don't know if you guys know or not. Let me show you the recipe for those. They look really good, too. Let me grab some clay. Yeah, get clay in here. Yep. I'll grab 24 because I know it's a four clay thingamajig. Oh, that's not it. Brick. There we go. So these brick pavers, they're not strong. You do not want to build anything out of these. But when you put them out, they look really good. Okay. How much do I trust my defenses? So what I'm anticipating doing here is basically to put out brick, like here. I'll just go up one more, that doesn't hurt. And then I want to do a kind of a brick interior patio throughout all of this. I think that'll look good. But yep. Yeah, I feel safe. I feel like they really can't get to me. Alright, I'm going to do another jump cut, and when I come back, we will be in the city, and we're going to go ahead and... Hey. Oh, don't fall on the spikes. Don't fall on the spikes. That's weird. So a zombie got that far. Yeah, that window's missing from there. It was a broken window. Okay. And they took out some of my ladders. So, that's not good. I do need to think about that. So, anyway, we'll do a jump cut, and when we come back, we'll be at the city, and we're going to do a little bit more looting. So, I will see you guys there.